Okay, once again, good morning. I think almost all have entered in the room. 19 are there. So I will share the screen. Yesterday we were discussing about this Bezier's theorem. The remark on here: if f of x and g of x are two non-zero polynomials, non-zero is important. F of x and g of x are two non-zero polynomials in the polynomial ring, this polynomial ring. Then there exist two polynomials u of x and v of x whose degree will not exceed. The coefficient of f of x is u of x. And coefficient of g of x is v of x. So you have to check cross degree, because, or you can logically you can think about that. The degree of u of x is greater than, is less than degree of g of x, and degree of u of x is less than degree of f of x. So that product will maintain the degree of both. That is the logic behind that. And the another important remark: if one have like number GCD of H and G is 1, and then how to find GCD of F into H comma G? Already G and H is GCD 1, so it is nothing but GCD of F and G. What is GCD of F with G is same as GCD of F into H into G. While applying division algorithm, you need to find this coefficient ux and vx always. When Bezier's theorem you need to apply, you need to find this always. So these two are the important remarks. Just think on it. Nothing else. Now here we will discuss what is the similarity between the set of integer and the polynomial ring. What similarity is there, analogous between z and integer? Here the character, here z is defined, z's properties, and here the polynomial ring f of x. You know the definition of both. First of all, I must say that this is an integral domain. And it is also integral domain. So both are integral domain. Both are Euclidean ring. Both are also Euclidean ring. Or you can say Euclidean domain. Both are Euclidean ring. You know the definition of Euclidean ring or Euclidean domain. You can define the function from that non-zero integral domain to non-negative integer, satisfying certain conditions. One is the division algorithm conditions, one is non-negativity conditions. And it is equal to zero if and only the element is zero, like that. Three conditions satisfying means it is Euclidean ring. So both are Euclidean rings, both are integral domain. And here, element, what do you call element of this Z? You just call it as integer M. The element in Z, it is just called it as integer M. See here, M belongs to Z. Whenever some element belongs to Z, you just call it as integer 1, integer 2, like this. And element in this polynomial ring is called polynomial. Element of polynomial ring is called polynomial. This is analogous. Here in set of integer, we can say the prime number P. So instead of prime number P, in the polynomial ring, we can say irreducible polynomial. So prime is analogous to here. The irreducible polynomial. Some element is prime means in the here, if you don't say prime, you can say it as irreducible, and we know the definition of irreducible. Yesterday we have discussed it. Now here modulo integer moduli m is defined. Set up all integer moduli m. It is also isomorphic to z by the subgroup generated by m. Both are isomorphic. These are the collection of cosets which is equivalent to this. equivalence classes. So these two sets are isomorphics, and this is the set integer modulium. So in the polynomial, since it is Euclidean ring, and you know in Euclidean ring every ideal is principal ideal. So the ideal generated by some polynomial f of x, this is the ideal generated by some polynomial. Here you write ideal generated by m, and here you write ideal generated by f of x. So this is the quotient ring. This is one example of quotient ring, polynomial ring by the ideal R by I. And how the element, suppose its degree is known to you. Suppose f of x is having degree n, you are writing the polynomial ring quotient some ideal generated by f of x, and let f of x is have degree n, then it must have the form, means you are all the polynomials divided by degree n polynomial, and you just write the remainders. So it must have this form. What you write here, this is a set of all integers when divided by m lose this much remainder. So when you divide by degree n polynomial, it will leave at most n minus 1 degree remainder. So a naught plus a1 x plus and so on, a n minus 1 x raised to n minus 1. And once again, these are the feed elements. So this type of elements will be here, and by example we can see how one can construct such type of elements. So this is a integer modulo, and this is the quotient ring. The analogous to the integer modulo is this. Now in the integer modulo, once integer modulo is known, you can define two operations. You have shown that this is also ring, and then it is called as quotient ring. So the addition is defined like this. You just add simply as of z, as of the set of integer addition, but while writing addition you have to divide by m and write the remainder. As same similarly to the multiplication, usual multiplication of set of integer, but whenever this multiplication you just write the remainder divided by m, that is mod m, ab mod m. Ab mod m means ab number is divided by m, and you are writing the remainder value. Likewise here addition is defined, it is just polynomial addition, this polynomial addition, and just divide by this f of x and write the remainder. You are interested in remainder, write the remainder. And once polynomial f of x has degree n, you know the remainder must have degree at most n minus 1. That's why I have written the polynomial of this form. Similarly, the multiplication is defined. So this is addition and multiplication analogous between z and polynomial ring. Now here, once you define these operations, you have shown that it is a ring. And here also it is a ring. And when this ring is called feed, till then you can mark your attendance. So if somebody have forgot to attendance, please mark that. Once it is ring, can you think of when it will be feed? And we know that ZP is a free if and only P is a prime, like this. So ZM is feed if and only BM is prime, and the analogous to prime is irreducible. So likewise here, this quotient ring will be feed. This is your finite feed. Huh? If F is finite, this F is finite, then it will be finite feed. This is your field if and only if whatever ideal generated by polynomial f of x at that polynomial f of x has to be irreducible. So this is all about analogous between the integer ring and polynomial ring. As a matter of analogous, we will discuss it. So we will discuss it. And if you have any questions, you can study it in detail. So I think in the analogy, will not find any difficulty here. If yes, please mention in the chat. Otherwise, we move further in the next slide. Okay, this is explained by this example. We'll have this example. Now see here, your F field is Z2. Binary field is given, and you are writing first polynomial ring. What is polynomial? Any degree polynomial. All the coefficients are binary, and n is, this is polynomial ring. And you want to consider some ideal generated by polynomial. Means all the multiple of it. Who is that? 1 plus x square. It means वन प्लस एक्स स्क्वेअर च्या मल्टिपल मध्ये सर्व जी ऑफ एक्स बिलॉन्ग्स टू एफ ऑफ एक्स, जी ऑफ एक्स बिलॉन्ग्स टू एफ ऑफ एक्स लाइक दैट। जसं की आपण सेट ऑफ इंटीजर मध्ये 2z किंवा जनरेट बाय 2 पाहतो, तर जनरेट बाय 2 आपण काय लिहितो 2 इंटू के, सच दॅट के इज इंटीजर। शेवटी के इक्वल टू 0, के इक्वल टू 1, के इक्वल टू मायनस 1, के इक्वल टू 2, के इक्वल टू मायनस 2 अँड सो ऑन लाईक दॅट। यू आर रायटिंग ऑल द पॉलिनॉमियल्स विच आर मल्टिपल ऑफ दिस, सो मल्टिप्लाय बाय एव्हरी पॉलिनॉमियल इन दिस पॉलिनॉमियल रिंग। सो दिस इज द सेट। नाउ वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड द element of it. So how you write these elements? I will just once again write the notationally, polynomial ring factor by ideal generated by f of x. This is which set it is? All the polynomials. Now I have to use different notations. All the polynomials modulo f of x. Factor means all the polynomials modulo f of x. And who are they? This is the polynomial ring. You are writing g of x from polynomial. So modulo f of x means f of x ne bhag dyaycha sarva polynomials, all polynomials. Ani remainder yel tithe kai tari. Bhagakar kai kai na? F of x ne sarva polynomial la bhag dyaycha. Kontya degree cha polynomial aso f of x ne bhag dila. तर यामध्ये बाकी काय असेल नेहमी? आता डिग्री 2 ने आपण भाग दिला, इफ यू डिवाइड बाय डिग्री 2 विल नॉट गेट रिमाइंडर ऑफ डिग्री 2 और मोर दॅन डिग्री 2 बाय द डिव्हिजन ऑल्गोरिथम। व्हॉट एव्हर डिग्री आयदर दॅट दॅट डिव्हिजन इज 0, इफ डिव्हिजन इज इफ रिमाइंडर डिव्हिजन इफ डिव्हिजन इज कम्प्लीट डिव्हिजन मीन्स रिमाइंडर इज 0, देन आर एक्स बिकम 0। बट इफ आर एक्स इज नॉन 0 देन इट्स डिग्री हॅज टू बी स्ट्रिक्टली लेस दॅन 2। So degree less than 2 means what? It is of at most 1 degree. So it is of this form always. A plus bx. Remainder. And a and b are the coefficients from binary field. So this is always this. And now you know the choices of a. One can take a equal to 0, b equal to 0. One can take a equal to 1, b equal to 0. One can take a equal to 0, b equal to 1, and last option is one can take both as 1 because field has only 2 elements. So that's why a has 2 choices, b has 2 choices, simultaneously a and b have total 4 choices as counting rule. So this set is written here. When you divide by 1 plus x square to any polynomial ring, you must have these form elements, and you know z2 only consists of 2 elements, so there will be 2 square means 4 elements. So if its degree is n, suppose you are writing this, if this f is finite field and you are writing quotient ring by f of x, if f of x has degree n, then it always has this number of element raised to n like that. Because you can see here you are taken degree 2 here. When you take degree 2, the remainder polynomial has this form a plus bx. At most degree 1 lays apela a and b 0 asal to 0 polynomial in constant in kiwa degree 1 in. So these are the only 4 choices, so always keep in mind this. So like that this table is prepared. Now addition is defined. We know how addition is defined. Now as you just usual add 0 plus 0 modulo the polynomial means you have to divide it by and write the remainder. But as per addition is concerned, you don't need to divide it by 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0, so 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus x is x, 0 plus 1 plus x, first row is okay. First row and first column is okay. I will see here 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1. 2 in the binary field, meaning of 2 is 0. So this 1 plus this x gives 1 plus x. Next, this 1 plus 1 plus x. 1 plus 1 plus x is 1 plus 1 is 2. So it is 2 plus x, but in binary field meaning of 2 is 0, so it is x. So x plus 0, x plus 1, you write it as 1 plus x, x plus x, 2x. 2x means it is 0 into x because in the binary meaning of 2 is 0. Coefficient lethani modulo 2 leche. And polynomial power lethani modulo degree 2 lesser. So it is x plus 1 plus x. So you can easily see 0 is additive identity, additive inverse of 1 is 1, additive inverse of x is x, and additive inverse of 1 plus x is x. So he pratyek jan swatah ch inverse hai. Pratyek jan swatah ch inverse hai manje ha Klein 4 group sarkha dishtoy mala addition madhe. Klein 4 group madhe kay astha, pratyek element cha order he 2 asta. Identity order ki nemi 1 asta, par non identity element ghetla tar pratyek element cha order hi kay 2 hai. So ha Klein 4 group hai. म्हणजे सायक्लिक नाही आहे. एनिवे दिस इज अबाउट ॲडिशन. आवर मेन इंटरेस्ट इज ऑन रिगार्डिंग मल्टिप्लिकेशन. विल मूव फॉर मल्टिप्लिकेशन टेबल. नाऊ आय विल शो द मल्टिप्लिकेशन हियर. सो दिस इज इझी. द झिरो इज मल्टिप्लाय टू एव्हरी एलिमेंट इन द फर्स्ट रो गिव्ह झिरो. सो फर्स्ट रो फर्स्ट कॉलम गिव्ह झिरो. इनफॅक्ट इन ॲज पर द ॲडिशन इज कन्सर्न we have to check my non-zero multiplicative inverse. So for closure property you should mention in the table, because you are verifying all the 10 conditions, all the 10 conditions from the table only. So what is 1 into 1 here? 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into x is x, 1 into 1 plus x is 1 plus x, x into 0 is 0, x into 1 is x, x into x is x squared. Now you may have question how the x square x into x is x. So you have to write this. You are going to write modulo this. And so what you are doing, you are dividing x square by x square plus 1 and try to find remainder. So we will try to find remainder. You must have x square here. So multiply by 1. It is x square plus 1 and subtract it 0 minus 1. In the binary, the meaning of 0 is 1. So remainder is 1. So that's why I write x square equal to 1. Next, we'll try to find how x into 1 plus x is 1 plus x. Next part we'll see how this x into 1 plus x. So what is calculation x into 1 plus x? X into 1 plus x is x plus x square. And how it becomes 1? We have to find remainder. Because you are finding modulo x square plus 1. So here you must have x square, so that means you are multiplying by 1. So x square plus 1, right, minus x minus 1. And minus 1 in the binary, additive inverse of 1 is plus 1. Binary madhe minus 1 ha 1 la common sa ya in the binary. So while in the binary field, no need to subtract, you just add it. Nothing it. So this in this way, x square plus x is x square plus x modulo x square plus 1 is 1 plus x. So you can see here. Now next, 1 plus x into 1 is 1 plus x multiplication. Ita tes aahe puna x square plus x ka 1 plus x ki. Ani ata ya doghancha multiplication 1 plus x into 1 plus x ha yeto x square plus 2x plus 1. 2x is 1 actually. Ani x square plus x la teres bhag dila तर बाकी झिरो येते. म्हणजे इथं रिमाइंडर झिरो आला. आणि तसं लक्षात आला असेल तुम्हाला की 1 प्लस एक्स हा झिरो डिवायझर आहे या रिंगमध्ये. 1 प्लस एक्स नॉन झिरो, 1 प्लस एक्स नॉन झिरो, पण त्यांचा प्रॉडक्ट काय आला? झिरो आला. म्हणजे ही विथ झिरो डिवायझर आहे, इंटिग्रल डोमेन नाही आहे. इंटिग्रल डोमेन नाही म्हणजे हे फील्ड असणार नाही. दिस इज नॉट फील्ड. इफ इट नॉट फील्ड मीन्स व्हॉट युअर पॉलिनॉमियल यू आर रिटर्न, इट मस्ट बी रेड्युसिबल. सो इट्स रेड्युसिबिलिटी tell us that x square plus 1 can be written as x plus 1 into x plus 1. So this is less than degree of this strictly. So it can be factorized. It can be factorized into product of two non-units and it is not invertible. So that's why the polynomial is reducible. Once polynomial is reducible, the ring by reducible polynomial implies it is not field. Ring by irreducible polynomial will imply field. So we'll see one more example regarding this. This is just string. This is just string. It is not field. This is not field. Keep in mind this z2x by 1 plus x square is not field. MCQ sathi apan direct pahu shakto. He adds 1 plus x square is reducible. वन प्लस एक्स स्क्वेअर इज रेड्यूसिबल पॉलिनॉमियल. ते का खाली दिलेलं क्वेश्चन फॅक्टर लिहिलं पॉलिनॉमियल रेड्यूसिबल असेल तर ते फक्त रिंग असते, फील्ड असणार नाही ती, कारण मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह नॉन झिरो एलिमेंटचं मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स एक्झिस्ट असणार नाही. आता इथे पाहूया आपण, वन मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह आयडेंटिटी दिसते आपल्याला, एक्स इंटू समथिंग वन आलं कुठं तर एक्स इंटू एक्स वन आलं, म्हणजे एक्स चा इन्व्हर्स एक्स आहे, पण वन प्लस एक्सचा मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स मिळणार नाही तुम्हाला वन प्लस एक्सचा. काय मिळतो इथे, वन प्लस एक्सचा एक्सचा मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स कोण आहे, इथलं कॅल्क्युलेशन बघा काय आलं आहे, हे वन लिहिलं आहे तिथं, वन वन प्लस एक्स इंटू एक्स, एक्सचा मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स कोण आहे पहा, एक्सचा मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स वन प्लस एक्स आहे. नाही एक्सचा इन्व्हर्सच एक्झिस्ट नाही आहे इथे, हे झिरो डिवायजर आलेच पाहिजे, इन्व्हर्स असेल तर युनिक नाही पण ते हेही लक्षात येते. एक्स इंटू एक्स पण वन येतं आहे एकदा, एक्स इंटू एक्स इथं, सॉरी हा ॲडिशन टेबल आहे मल्टिप्लिकेशन बघत आपण, दिस इज ॲडिशन टेबल इन द मल्टिप्लिकेशन टेबल विल सी. हां या ठिकाणी पहा, इथे पहा आता एक्सचा इन्व्हर्स हा एक्स आहे, एक्स हॅज मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स एक्स, वन हॅज मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स वन, अँड दिस इज द थर्ड नॉन झिरो एलिमेंट हुज प्रॉडक्ट इज, याचा प्रॉडक्ट या रो आणि या कॉलममध्ये कुठेच वन येत नाही, म्हणजे वन प्लस एक्सचा मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स नाही, तर अशा प्रकारे तो फील्ड नाही. एव्हरी नॉन झिरो एलिमेंट हॅज मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स इन अ फील्ड अँड दॅट कंडिशन डझंट होल्ड, दॅट्स वाय इट इज जस्ट स्ट्रिंग. नाव विल सी एक्झाम्पल, अनदर एक्झाम्पल, नाव इन शे टू जस्ट चेक वेदर दिस पॉलिनॉमियल इज रेड्युसिबल ऑर इरेड्युसिबल, वन प्लस एक्स प्लस एक्स स्क्वेअर, वेदर दिस पॉलिनॉमियल इज रेड्युसिबल ऑर इरेड्युसिबल, यू कॅन चेक इट. आय कॉल इट एज नाव जी ऑफ एक्स. सो इन झेड टू रेड्युसिबल म्हणजे त्याचे रूट आहे की नाही तेवढंच पाहिजे तुम्हाला. तर जी ऑफ झिरो काय येत आहे, वन प्लस झिरो प्लस झिरो स्क्वेअर दॅट इज वन विच इज नॉन झिरो, सो झिरो इज नॉट रूट ऑफ दिस पॉलिनॉमियल, अँड जी ऑफ वन, वन प्लस वन प्लस वन स्क्वेअर इट इज थ्री, थ्री मीन्स वन विच इज ऑल्सो नॉन झिरो, सो नायदर झिरो इज रूट नॉर वन इज रूट, मीन्स यू कॅनॉट हॅव लिनियर फॅक्टर हियर, डिग्री टू मस्ट हॅव टू लिनियर फॅक्टर्स, सो वी कॅनॉट फॅक्टराइज इट, वी कॅनॉट फॅक्टराइज इट मीन्स इट इज इरिड्युसिबल, इट इज इरिड्युसिबल पॉलिनॉमियल. वन्स इट इज इरिड्युसिबल, व्हॉट एवर रिंग यू हॅव रिटन हियर, दिस हॅज टू बी फील्ड, इट इज फील्ड. आणि मग आता इथे मल्टिप्लिकेटिव्ह इन्व्हर्स वगैरे सगळ्या गोष्टी काय होतील ऑटोमॅटिक होल्ड होतील. आता ॲडिशन टेबल एझी, आता आपल्या आपण पुन्हा एकदा काय केलं पाहिजे मग अशासारखंच, जर तुम्ही कोणतंही पॉलिनॉमियल घेतलं आपलं आणि मॉड्युलो वन प्लस एक्स वर केलं, मीन्स यू आर डिवायडिंग एनी पॉलिनॉमियल बाय डिग्री टू पॉलिनॉमियल, सो व्हॉट आर द पॉसिबल रिमाइंडर्स, वी मस्ट हॅव ॲटमोस्ट डिग्री वन रिमाइंडर, सो देअर विल बी फोर पॉसिबिलिटीज फॉर दिस, ए प्लस बी एक्स, A and B are the elements from binary field. So likewise, A and B will take 0, A 0, B as 1. Okay, one can take A 0 and A equal to 1. In that case, B is 0. One can take B as 1, A as 0. One can take both as 1. So these are the only four possibilities. Similar field is there, but quotient is this, just keep in mind, the quotient is this, ring modulo this, you have to write. So addition is easy, you can check it, 0 plus 0, 0 plus 1, 0 plus x, 0 plus 1 plus x. So first row and first column, inner first row and first columns are okay, you can see that 0 is the additive identity in that ring. I will not say at present it has field, 1 plus 1 is 0, so 1 has additive inverse 1. 1 plus x is 1 plus x, 1 plus x is x, x plus 0, x plus 1 is 1 plus x, x plus x is 2x, and 2x, 2x means, 2x लिहितो आपण, या 2 चा अर्थ आपला जे 2 मध्ये 2 इलेमेंट नाही आहे, जे 2 मध्ये 2 चा अर्थ काय असतो, 0x, 2 इज कॉमनस टू 0, मॉड्युलो 2, सो इन जे 2, 2 मीन्स 0, दॅट्स वाय यू आर रायटिंग, इन्स्टेड ऑफ 2x यू आर रायटिंग 0, सो x plus 1 plus x इट इज 1 plus 2x. And what is 1 plus 2x? 1 plus 2x is 2 means 0. 1 plus 2x is 1. So like that. 1 plus x plus 0 is 1 plus x, 1 plus x plus 1 is x, 1 plus x is 1, and 1 plus x plus 1 plus x is 2 plus 2x, that is 0, 2 is 0. While you be careful, the coefficients are from binary field. So as per the operations concerned, you have to be care with the coefficients also. Always you write coefficient modulo 2 when your field is binary. If it is modulo 3, if it is modulo p, according to that we have to write the coefficients always. So addition table is okay, there is no problem in the addition table. Now we'll see the multiplication table once again here. As per the 0 is concerned, 0 into anything will be 0. So first column and first row you can see. No need to calculate about this. For the closeness of multiplication, you need to consider this. Otherwise, you have to check every non-zero element has multiplicative inverse. So as per 1 is concerned, 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into x is x. 1 into 1 plus x is 1 plus x. Multiplication as usual, x into 1, x into x. Now we'll see x into x. X into x is x squared. And you have to write modulo what? It is 1 plus x square. So you must have x square here. To get x square, you should multiply by 1. So 1 into this whole thing is x square plus x plus 1. So subtract x square minus x square. In binary, no need to subtract. You can just add x square plus x square is 2, x square and 2 become 0. So otherwise, you have to write minus x minus 1 as 1 plus x. Because minus 1 stands for additive inverse. My negative means additive inverse of 1 in Z2. So minus 1 additive inverse kon hai? So 2 1 hai. One only one lila. So minus x can be written as x and minus 1 can be written as 1. So in this way, this x square is congruous to this x square is congruous to x into x. X square is congruous to 1 plus x modulo your polynomial. So you are interested in remainder. So you are writing x into x as 1 plus x square. Next, x into 1 plus x. What is the value of x into 1 plus x? PCL find करायचे आपल्याला हा x आणि हा 1 plus x. तो 1 दाखवायचा आहे. X into 1 plus x. It is x square plus x. Now you are dividing by once again x square plus x plus 1. याने divide करायचे कोणाला x square plus x ला आणि आपला remainder मध्ये interest आहे. So you must have x square here to cancel it. So x to get x square, you must multiply by 1. So x square plus x plus 1 as it is. So subtract it. This becomes 0, this becomes 0. And minus 1. Minus 1 is nothing but 1. So remainder is 1. That's why this remainder is 1. Now 1 plus x into 0 is 0. 1 plus x into is 1 plus x. 1 plus x into x after calculate kelapun to 1 eto. And last la 1 plus x and 1 plus x calculation karate. So who is 1 plus x? Shevatchi cell karta apun matrix madhi 1 plus x multiply by 1 plus x. It is 1 plus x square. 2x apun 0 gato ita. 1 plus 2x plus 2x square. As the field is binary, since its characteristics is 2, 2 and 3 element will become 0. So the 1 plus x into 1 plus x is x square plus 1. 2x become 0. So be careful writing over which field you are calculating. And you are dividing by x square, right from highest degree, decreasing order always, x square plus x plus 1. And you need to cancel this x square. So to get x square, you should multiply by 1 here. So multiplication of this with 1 is x square plus x plus 1 as it is. And now just subtract it. X square minus x square get cancelled, plus 1. Minus 1 and minus x is nothing but plus x, because minus 1 is congruence to 1 modulo 2. That's why I'm writing here. So in this way you get x here. Now here you easily see, as per the multiplication is concerned, this one is multiplicative identity. What is inverse of this x? X la kashat multiplicator 1 ala. The inverse of x is 1 plus x. So it gives 1. And inverse of 1 plus x is x. So uniqueness of this inverse we can see. And this is multiplicative identity. So in this way, every non-zero element has multiplicative inverse. And this set will become field. Which set? Z2x factor by the irreducible polynomial 1 plus x plus x. Well, you write a decreasing order, I write increasing here, okay, is a field. As per the multiple choice or arbitrary constant is concerned, you need to just check that if this polynomial is irreducible. If this polynomial is irreducible, then this will be always field. This will always field. Now by using same terminology, I will show how the complex number will come into vectors. How complex numbers have been written here, we'll discuss, because I think this will be the last example that we want to discuss here. So I will share the notes. What I'm talking, how the complex numbers have been, how complex number might have been developed. So you're writing this R is field, real number, R stands for real number. AIR reals and n is integer greater than or equal to. It's not fixed degree, Anna. Now this is polynomial ring because R is field. This is polynomial ring. Just give me the one standard example of irreducible polynomial. So I will take f of x. I will take f of x as 1 plus x square. This is irreducible. We cannot factorize. It is irreducible over set of real numbers. We cannot factorize. There is no root. We know the roots of this equation. The roots of this equation is root of minus 1. But that we are going to check. So once it is irreducible, then this has to be filled. This set. And this field is isomorphic to your complex number. This is field. We have 4 minutes in left. I will try to finish it. And actually, this is not finite field. Because R is not finite. That's why I am taking infinite field example. So you can return this as. Now be careful, whatever degree polynomial you are just dividing by, you are just writing remainder when divided by. You just keep in mind, when you divide by degree to polynomial, you must have this polynomial a plus bx, where a and b are real number, where a and b are real number. So what is that x? Actually that x is your root of minus 1. That is imagined part. You by practice you can write it as a plus ib also, but we have to show that x square is minus 1. So here you can show how the x square is minus 1. So x is a part of this ring. X is a part of this ring because in this ring degree 1 polynomial you can consider, and again x is there. So x square, you need to find who, what is x square is congruence to who. X square, you need to find it is congruence to who. So actually within 1 minute we can check x square is congruence to who. So just divide by x square. you are writing by modulo x square plus 1. So you must have x square here. X square plus 1 get multiplication. So these two get cancelled, it is minus 1. So in the real number of minus 1 has meaning minus 1, division is 1. So it is congruence to minus 1. So it is congruence to minus 1. Or one can say x square can be written as x square plus 1 minus 1 modulo that polynomial. X square plus 1 when you 0 as though. X square plus 1 like x square plus 1 bhaag dila to 0 hai to modulo x square plus 1. So this means x square sartha kaay gala ita modulo x square plus 1 kila to x square sartha kaay gala. So while writing this set one can write rx factor by 1 plus x square, it is a plus bx. One more additional condition, what conditions? A and b are real number and x square is congruence to minus 1. X square mujhe x square congruence to minus 1, and by practice this is minus root of minus 1. Minus root of 1 will be denoted by, so it is just like a plus bi. A and b are the real number, so that's why these two are isomorphic rings. Notation you write different. This is nothing but C actually here. So likewise, the field of complex number has been 10. But we are not interested in infinite fields. We have to think on finite fields only. Put your video on, and if you find any difficulty, mention in the comment. Put your video on. The three participants have left. Somebody take screenshot of existing participant.